Greetings again, and welcome to a new traditional Shield of Kaldheim. This will be the final regular Shield event for now, and of course I will be participating in the Arena Open that will be happening on the weekend now. And I will of course upload every try of mine day one events there, and of course if I go to day two I will upload that video as well. Right, so I did get a mythic rare, which is nice. It's also it's not the most, you know, sickest limited mythic rare. Kaya definitely is the best. I mean, Thibault is of course insane too, but it's a 7 mana card. But Kaya as a 5 mana card is the best planeswalker in this limited set, for limited I mean. And Nico Aris is still definitely a card you will always play in your deck, and probably will be splashing. If you play blue, you can splash the single white cost easily. And then there's the Cosmos Charger, definitely goes to any blue deck. Battle of Frost and Fire, very nice saga. And Battle for Bredaguard, not that amazing. Still, I mean, of course, I won't be cutting this from any green-white deck, but this is not the card you will splash, for example. You have to be base green-white to play this. And then we have these black cards. I mean, the other one is black-red. Crippling Fear is one of the multiple wrath effects in this set. Definitely great, because this is not a symmetrical effect, unless the opponent has changelings or just simply the same creature types class included as you have. You can get at least partly a one-sided wrath by casting this. Of course, -3/-3 doesn't say destroy creature, so if opponent has anything with 4 or more toughness, those will survive too, but -3/-3 will hit a lot of creatures in this set. So that's definitely a fantastic quality card. And Immersturm Predator, this is just a straight 5 out of 5 A-grade card, because, I mean, look at the text here. Yeah, it's a 4 mana 3/3 flyer, so that's, I mean, for limited that's already good. But then again, it will continue growing, and then if you just have other creatures, it's also very difficult to get rid of. So I have a nice amount of rares here. I mean, amount will always be 6, but a nice selection of rares for different colors. I guess I don't have a green interesting rare here. I have 2 blue interesting rares, actually 3, because this is also interesting. And then there are 2 black ones, 2 red ones, and I guess 1 white one. So let's, I assume I will play at least some of these, hopefully. I mean, I guess ideally something like a Grixis would allow me to play 4 of these, and then I could just splash the Nico Aris for my Grixis deck. So I guess some kind of a blue, maybe it, I guess it would be like a black red. No, it has to be a blue. Well, I mean, whatever, it is what it is. Let's just make and see what the other cards are in this pool. And now I again try to be a little bit quicker than in the first few Shield events, because my deck building took a long, long time. I mean, you can of course just go, there's the chapter selection feature in the YouTube. You can just click the deck building or whatever it says currently, and you can go to the round one, and if you, you know, backtrack a little bit from that, you can also see the final deck without going through this my deck building process, if you are not really interested in that part. Right, so white, nothing exciting here, nothing exciting in here. Okay, well, I guess the Starnheim Corsair and Iron Verdict are okay. Story Seeker, I'm not sure how good that is in limited. I like the Valkyrie, Barakard is nice, God's Hall Guardian can be nice. So basically the only white card I'm interested is the Nico Aris, without having seen the uncommon golden cards yet. Blue, well, Anal, of course, nothing good. A Pinter Monster, it's a fine card. I don't think in Sealed deck you will have enough snow permanents. So this Frost Augur is unlikely to be good. Two cards are wasted here in this Brine Barrow Intruder. It's a, yeah, I mean, playable trick, but not really a high impact card. Double Glimpse the Cosmos. Well, this is a good card. Well, let's see if I have enough Giants or Changelings to get good value out of this thing. Of course, the Giant's Amulet will give me a Giant. can be okay. Raven form, okay, double Ogre Raven and the Cosmos Charger. There is a Zoid coming, this is... Well, I mean, in Sealed there are a lot of bumps, so definitely this goes to any blue deck. Inga is quite nice. Kinseekers, this is a giant and this is a good giant. I mean, this is good even if you have like a... I mean, not exciting if you have, a, let's say, two or three Snowlands, but still sometimes you get the additional effect from this and you can still play this, and especially with the double... come on, Glimsty Cosmos, definitely I will be playing any giants. How about the black one? Well, there's the way down here. There is the Crippling Fear indeed, but man, these other cards are not really that good. The Vengeful Reaper is, and that's the end of the black cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, I guess that's 13, but a lot of them are just very unexciting cards. I mean, this thing is so hard to splash as it is a double caster. I can splash the red, black-red flyer, of course. I mean, if I'm playing red, I will be able to splash that one, but this double caster, not so much. And I guess there's a little bit bigger chance in Sealed that the opponent plays bigger creatures. And maybe this doesn't get quite as many creatures as in draft, but it's still an excellent card I would definitely play. But let's see if I can play splash black at all. Here we have aggressive red cards. All of these are playable if I mean, I don't know how easy it's gonna be to play an aggressive red deck, but come on, look at these cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 red cards, and plus they're rare. Okay, so I definitely can't play red as my main color. So can I even play the red rare then? I also have the... I mean, yeah, if I would play black as my main color, I would play the red rare, but I don't think... Yeah, this looks pretty bad, actually, in terms of, you know, how many rares I can play. But maybe I'll just play blue and... Well, let's see the green first. Green didn't have any rares other than the green-white saga, which is not really a bomb or anything. Elven Bow is good, Arachnoform not so much, Masked Vandal fine. Okay, Path, yeah, this does enable with the Glittering Frost some kind of five color business. I mean, I could go five colors here now, I have some support for that. Let's see how many of those Simmedrift Whales I have here, or Dual Snowlands. Well, I mean, there are good cards in here, sure, and this Mentor is, I don't think it's that good in Sealed unless you have some kind of synergy for it somehow, but well, it's a playable card. Packmate definitely good, Spirit of Aldegard and Ravenous Lindworm, definitely all fantastic cards in Sealed. Well, I saw the Nico already, definitely great card. Great Hall of Stone. Well, I mean, all the uncommon lands are good in their respective colors, so I don't have to kind of, I mean, if I'm playing a deck that can make this cost, the ability activation cost happen, I will obviously include Great Hall of Starnheim in that deck. Ascent of the Worthy, not a good card. How can there are these good rares? There's a snow blue black dual, snow green black dual, Eldehald, very nice. Arni Slays the Troll is a fantastic card, and I have also the green white Fall of the Impostor. I have a double Goldwain Peak. I have Runed Crown, but did I have any runes here? Okay, that was all the cards actually. Not that many golden cards. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. I don't think I had any runes here. I have the Rune Eyes, but that's not a rune. So the Rune Crown is completely unplayable. You don't play a equipment that costs 3 to play and then 2 to equip at it, all it gives is +1/+1. But what caught my interest here is that I don't have any strong, I mean, I guess not even white is that great. I have a lot of white cards, but even they are not that great. I mean, I don't have enough good cards. The blue is fine. Blue has, I mean, I guess the blue has the highest concentration of quality cards, so blue could be my kind of a main color in here. But what really caught my eye is the double Goldwain Peak in here. I mean, this, I have the one Simmedrift Whale here, I have two Ender's Tapped Snow Duals, and I guess that means I will have four Snow Basic Lands. Yep, these are the other snowlands I opened. Path to the World Tree. I mean, I'm kind of interested in running all five here. My good cards are so spread, you know, between all these colors. Green has a few good cards here, and then this mana fixing Sculptor of Winter with all the six snowlands is quite interesting. So basically, what that would mean that let's see. That would be pretty much of a mess, but I mean, I guess it could be fun. This is the final sealed event I am playing before the Arena Open, and this is my fifth event. My four prior events were three times the maximum wins, which is four wins, and one time two wins. So even if I kind of lose here, go 0-2 or something here, I guess overall my sealed deck events here, the first five will be pretty good success events anyway. And but of course I'm not gonna just, you know, fool around here. I want to play the deck that gives me the biggest chance to victory. But I mean, what can it be? Like blue white, I could play the Nico Aris there and they have some late game white cards, a few early drops, but I mean something like a Battlefield Raptor. This is not good in sealed. It can be good in draft, but okay, I guess with double Goldwing Peak, yeah, I guess I could kind of have these evasive white cards. I have the Starnheim Corsair in here. Also something like Story Seeker on turn 2, and the peak costs 2 to play, 1 to equip. So a 2-2 on turn 2, and on turn 3 I can make this a 3-3 attacker. It's possible opponent doesn't have a good block and I get the treasure token right away. I have the Stalwart Valkyrie. I mean, I guess I could. Yeah, I see. I have the Ox Blow combo, but I don't see playing this combo. No. But I mean, I guess I could play like white as my main color too. Blue, I'm definitely going to play. That's for sure. I mean, I have enough here. There's not a lot of early blue, but the Glimpse the Cosmos. How many giants it is? God, that's not a giant. Giant. This is an ox, not a giant, but it's a giant ox. So that's why the things are. Okay, this is bad. I mean, I have only these things. That's two giants. And how about the changeling? Well, that, I mean, I don't want to run two of these main deck, but that makes the Glimpse the Cosmos a lot worse. I mean, it's not unplayable if you can't get the second cast of it, but that's what makes the card very good. It's no better than Strategic Planning if you don't get the second cast of it. Wow. So that really is only like, I mean, I can see playing one Masked Vandal main deck. Kin Seekers. This is taking, by the way, a lot more time than I hoped for, because I have a lot of decisions to make here. I guess I have like four. If I play both of these and then I have the Amulet and the Bergstrider, that's like four giants. So yeah, that gives some chance to cast these things. And this will of course be good. I mean, this is good even if you don't have any giants. You can wipe the board with this. You can play in such a way that it doesn't hurt you as much as it hurts the opponent. And this has other modes too. The Scry 3 and the Adapter 3 are no jokes. What am I gonna do with this pool? I have to just start building something. Yeah, the blue, I mean, the flyer is in blue and saw it coming. Glimpse, I think the blue is one of my main colors. But if I'm gonna play five colors, I would have to play green as my secondary main color. I'm not gonna splash the Glittering Frost. I would have to be able to cast it early. And also this double Sculptor is gonna be actually pretty fantastic with all my, I will have actually seven snowlands, because this is my seventh snowlands. This won't open up in the land slot. This is in the common slot. So I have six land slot snowlands, and then that is the seventh one. So I guess I'm interested in running blue and green as my main colors. I will forget about the Mentor. It's not such a high quality card. I put all the cards I'm interested in running, because if I'm gonna splash like all the colors, I'm not gonna run any unplayables. Even the Elven Bow is actually a card that I could see not playing at all. And this deck definitely needs the picks. I think that both picks if I'm gonna splash for all my colors. So let's see. And the best red card, Ymir Sturmpirator, Battle of Frost and Fire, Ahni Slays the Troll. I don't think I'm gonna play the Battle for Bretagard, but this has a nice chapter 3, so Fall of the Impostor I would be playing here. And then I think that's all the, well, I'm gonna play the Nico Aris. I'm actually, let's see how many cards I'm gonna actually play here, because I will have to make some cuts here now, because this is, I don't even have my blue here. I mean, I guess I could be just base green and forget about the early blue cards too. If I'm just gonna splash the actual good blue cards. Yeah, Nico Aris is a double caster, but yeah, I guess I'm gonna play a bit more inconsistent deck than I'm used to. Yeah, I kind of forget about all the other red. So that's two red cards that are very good. Don't have to care about the other ones. Although this is also enables the splash, but I just don't have enough red. I'm not gonna play a 2-mana 2-1s and 2-mana 2-2s in sealed deck. That's rarely gonna get there. And then the good black cards are, let's put them in first. I guess I can always play that way down. I guess I could play this double caster. Vengeful Reaper is good. And the Raise the Draugr, don't think it's gonna have two things to return that often. Okay. Those are the black cards I'm interested in playing. I don't have to play them, but I'm interested in playing. And then I'm gonna play six Snowlands. Actually seven, so Bergstrider is great. I could play the Kinseekers just because I'm gonna run the... Yeah, I'm gonna run the... Come on. So let's see. Glimpse the Cosmos, Giant's Amulet, Bind the Monster. Okay, I'm gonna have to... Maybe I don't play all five. Maybe I'll have to decide something. Yeah, I won't be playing all five colors. And then the white. White has the Nico. Am I gonna just not play any other white here? I mean, these are flyers. These are fine cards. But I guess they are not that amazing. Like, I will still play the Snow Plains because I want to have the, you know... I will play five colors because of this activation, but how many white cards I'm gonna play. I could see only playing one white card here, actually. So this deck is actually what I want to play here. And then I will just have to trim down to... I'm gonna play double pick in here. I have very few ways to... Now that I don't have any evasive creatures. Yeah, the pick is just not bad actually now. I have the Ogre Raven. I guess I can't just play the Crippling Fear. I mean, double black is just too harsh, yeah, I think. It could also be that I'm simply forgetting the Vengeful Reaper and the way down as well. I'm gonna splash only for the Ymir Sturm Predator here from black. And Nico Aris from white. This is actually a 5-drop. And of course, yeah, the Fall of the Impostor. I just like this a little, maybe too much, but I just like it. So, I think, but I do have the Ogre Ravens and the Cosmos Charger. They hold the Goldwayne Peak quite nicely after all. Also the Predator here. Nico Aris is, by the way, quite often more expensive than 3, but it could be a 3-drop too. Alright. Well. Tough question. This is something like a late drop too, because I don't have a... Am I gonna use this fight ability? I guess I have enough. Don't have that many good creatures to fight with after all. I mean, I could see not playing this. I just like the chapter 2. You get two permanent counters also. Chapter 3 is here and there. It's not necessarily always that useful. Yeah, I can see cutting the Elven Bow. Especially if I'm playing double peak in here. I don't actually have many triggers for this chapter 3 here. basically, if I cast, yeah, this I can cast for 5 mana or more, then this will trigger it. The Lindworm and the Bergstrider. That's actually only 3 cards in here, because this is, while it's a 5 drop, it's a 1 mana spell only. I mean, I could see not playing the Arnis Laced Troll, and I maybe could see cutting one of the picks now that my splashes are actually quite modest now at this point. And I would have one more cut. I don't like to cut the Kinseekers because of the Glimpse of Cosmos. Otherwise, it's the worst card in the deck. The Rune Eyes is good. The Masked Vandal, same story. Because of the Glimpse of Cosmos, I don't want to cut it. And usually there will be targets for it. That is true, actually. I mean, am I gonna just not play the Rune Eyes? I like the Scry 3 and the, you know, the potential to draw 3 here. I don't have, by the way, a lot of removal here. That's weird. I have a Pinter Monster, and I have the Counterspell in here, and then the Fall of the Imposter. That's kinda it, but I guess this pool just doesn't have... I don't have a White Pacifism effect, no. I have an Iron Verdict. Does that mean I'm gonna actually play it? I suppose it is something I would be playing. So maybe if I cut the Inga here after all, I have a bunch of force here. I mean, yeah, these have Fortel, but still... Is the Battle of Frost and Fire just not gonna be good enough? I mean, I could see playing this like as a sideboard card rather than a main deck card. I could also just, you know, consider playing 16 lands because I have the Path to the World Tree, which is kind of a land. And these Glimpse the Cosmos, this will find me lands. This will kill all of my guys. Also my Nico Aris. I mean, I have a few giants, but that's about it. My flyers will die. My changelings won't die. It would feel weird to not use this, but yeah, there's the Scry 3. That's a good one. Maybe I'll just check out if I play 16 lands and how it would seem. I see my colors, you know, reliable here. I also have the Spirit of the Alder Garden here. I mean, I could see playing it like this. And I blank the Iron Verdict only because I have so few removal spells here. That's the only reason. The pool didn't have like a Black Has the Way Down and something like that. Well, there's the Crippling Fear, and I suppose the Wither Crown is semi-removal. Well, let's just put all the lands here. Simmerdrift Whale, definitely this go, and this will... double white, double black. Well, thanks to the Glittering Frost and this Sculptor of Winter, I guess I have chance to make anything, you know, make any kind of double mana happen. It's not gonna be that likely, but I'll just play a few tapped lands. I'll leave with that, so put the snow lands here. How many snow permanents I will have? That's 7 snow lands, Bergstrider 8, Tiswin 9, 10, that's actually 12, so Frost Ogre has more than 50% chance on average to hit into a card. I just don't see... No, I don't want to cut anything else. This will be the deck. So this is actually a green-blue base card and base deck, and you see here. But there's actually more blue cards than green cards, and just a few other colors. So I would have to have like, let's see if these lands of non-green, non-blue lands are this enough as is. So let's count. Well, I mean, how do I look at first the white mana? There's only one plains, but I have only, I guess, 3 white cards, but then again I have to pick the Glittering Frost. I have the Path to the World Tree basically gets, that counts as one of each mana. I have the Glimpse the Cosmos to find stuff. Yeah, one plains is enough. How about the swamp? I have actually Woodland Chasm and the Great Hall of Starnheim here too, and the Snow Swamp, so I won't be needing any other black because I have only one black card here. And then red. I have a. And of course, the Simmerit Veil functions as a, any color too, but only will be producing. I mean, this is not so great in a five color deck because you often have to name one of the several colors you want to name with it, so you can't fix your mana with single Simmerit Veil, but it's still of course going to be a good help. Anyway, Snow Mountain, and that is it. I have two red cards here, but they are Snow Mountain, Path to the World Tree, and Glittering Frost. That's three ways to get red mana source. I have the Goldwing Pig, and of course the Spirit of the Elder God can get me a Snow Mountain, as well as the Simmerit Veil. So that's enough. So let's see the green blue. So I will actually move, for example, all lands that don't produce green or blue in the sidelines here. And that is indeed currently I'm going to run 16 lands. I'm gonna test if I run 16 lands how bad my mana is gonna look like. This is like a joker, so wild card or something like that. That's two blue, that's two green. The good news is that the Spirit of the Elder God can find any color here. Not untapped source for any color, even if I have already played the Simmerdrift Veil. I can find the Woodland Chasm that's black and green, I can find the island or tunnel for blue, I can find the white and red sources as well, so that's all the colors. Oh, by the way, if I want that path to the World Tree finds me, it can find a plains. Plains, swamp, and mountain, and I will definitely play islands and forests, so it will find me everything too. That's fantastic. Yeah, this deck is, I don't know, we'll see. I like it, but it's gonna be a bit inconsistent. However, here I'm gonna add 7 more lands, so I guess 3 and 3 is the starting point here. So 3 islands. What do I do with this? Let's take Mark Pool. And then it's gonna be Green Forests, Mark Pool. And that's like 5 for both. There's the Simmerdrift Veil. Yep. I mean, this is bad. This is going to be inconsistent. And I even have like a basically a green fixer, so this need green, this Glittering Frost and the Path to the World Tree. And this is kind of fixing too. The Glimpse the Cosmos can help me find certain colors of mana. And it's gonna be, it requires blue. So I guess I would want to have one other mana source for both of these. That would be like a 6 sources here and then 7th in the Simmerdrift Veil. So most of my starting hands should have like at least something. but I would need to cut a card in that case. What's the card to cut? I mean, these are all needed cards for different reasons. I'm kind of actually thinking about the Battle of Frost and Fire here. Okay, I'll sideboard it in. That's actually crazy, but it's possible it doesn't really do that much. This is sealed. Opponent could have changelings, giants, creatures with high toughness. And the sad thing about that card, I don't have more than 3 ways to trigger the third chapter, so that's one reason why if I would have more ways to trigger the third chapter, then I would be more inclined to run it. But yeah, I'll try it and I will sideboard it. And it could be that I'm sideboarding it against all decks, but we'll see. So this is it. So that's like 6 green sources, 6 blue sources, and then the Simmerdrift Veil that can be one or the other. So I hope to have a starting hand with one of these green sources. I mean, a starting hand that has at least one green or blue source, and then if it doesn't have both, then it has the, you know, the color, correct color of fixer, like the Glimpse the Cosmos if I happen to have blue, or Blast Path to the World Tree, or a Glittering Frost if I, you know, I'm having the green sources. Anyway, that's the deck. That's gonna be crazy. I usually don't play quite this quite these crazy mana bases, but now I do. But I don't want this unplayable black card to be the picture here. I think I'll take the Predator here. I'm still not gonna let the opponent start here. Okay, but like I said, if I have a blue source, I want to have a glimpse of the cosmos. Glimpse the cosmos, so that's okay. I will find the green mana. I mean, of course, I might not find it, but I can find the green mana with this. Either way, any mana will let me cast the Imbersturm Predator. And okay, that's interesting. Because... That's actually interesting. Am I gonna go for the, you know, quick flying beats? Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that. Besides, I might, you know, draw the green source naturally, then I can use this to get a spell instead of a land. Okay, why the War Master has to be there? Not that 2-drop. I mean, it's okay if they don't have a lot of elves to continue with, but of course black and green easily can have those things. Okay, that's fine. And now I will try to find. Let's see, my white and red cards are not ones that I can cast with these mana, so. A forest would be the best. Oh, there's an Elder Hall, which is second best. And no reason to attack. I mean, if they're gonna attack with the Recluse, I'm just gonna block the Recluse. So let's see, this went to the bottom in a order of my choosing, right? It doesn't let me choose it though. Yeah, I think it works so that if your library is small enough, then it actually will let you choose the order. Why the Disciple here? I mean, the Sculptor of Winter is kinda... But it can block all these 1/1s, yeah. I think I have to trade with the Recluse here. But yeah, this is sort of unnecessary now. Or is the Fall of the Impostor just a little bit too much? Okay, I guess the Fall of the Impostor is just a little bit too much. It takes quite a long time. I do like the +1/+1 counters, but not ideal. So yeah, I'm gonna do that thing. Opponent will be able to start attacking with longbow, but I will have the at least the sculptor will be here. Okay, well there is that too. So what I planned to do was to play the Glittering Frost on maybe on the like on the mountain, and then I could play the Sculptor of Winter, and then I would have a bunch of mana. But I could also play the Spirit of the Elder God, which is able to block the longbow. Yeah, let's do that. What snow source it's gonna get? I have all the colors in here. Actually, all the colors are here in four lands here. So, do I need? Well, the chasm is just strictly better than the swamp. Simidrift Vale. I mean, that's only gonna produce one. So, and I don't need the white or red source anymore. Of course, with the Glittering Frost, I have pretty much everything here. I guess it's just gonna be the chasm after all. Yeah, it is, because this is actually a double black card, so now I will need only a green source to actually trigger this thing. I can kill the War Master before it becomes a problem when they hit 7th land. And of course, now that I got the green source, I have the double green here without... I mean, if I draw an untapped land, I might just play the Lindworm, who knows? Okay, that needs two land steel for the War Master. Okay, so they have something here. Let's see how many they attack with. It could be a Jarl of the Forsaken if they attack with... Oh, well, they can do that, but at least that uses two of their cards. So that's definitely a trade I'm willing to take here. I guess I'm gonna just... I mean, could just play the Lindworm here. They don't get to activate this thing yet. Otherwise, I could enchant the island with the Glittering Frost, and then I would have still 4 mana and play the Immerus Tomb Predator. But I can't protect this when I don't have other creatures. So yeah, let's just play the 6 mana card here. They had removal for my 4/4. Let's see if they have removal for my 6/6. If they have something like an exile target creature, I can't imagine they would have used but they do. So did they actually just? Okay, they were saving this for some bomb. Doesn't matter though, because my bomb is still here. Kinseekers, Elf Rogue, Vampire Dragon, can't get the trigger for this quite yet. I could now just... Well, not quite yet, I need a green and... Oh, okay, so can't kill this thing yet, but they missed their land drop, which of course also means that they have 2 spells in the hand. But yeah, I will be able to kill the War Master on the next turn, because now I'm going to do like... this, and I mean I could play this now, and if they don't have a third removal spell it's gonna be good. Otherwise I have played this. Okay, this thing blocks the 1/1s. Okay, fine, I can play this next turn then, and I have creatures to sacrifice then with this Sculptor of Winter and the Glittering Frost. I actually have a lot of mana available. That's actually 9 mana I have available, but they have a way down. I mean, the way down would have also dealt with this, although, yeah, this wouldn't have, the indestructible wouldn't have helped there. Coldwind Peak. Okay, well now, oh man, that was annoying, because now I can't kill the War Master with them. And they get, okay, that was the perfect thing for them. Yeah. Because now they get to 7 mana with the, and then I can't kill that thing. Why they put the rune on the creature and not the pig? I don't get it. Anyway, problem here is that they can start activating this thing, and it's gonna make them big guys there. I can play both of these, but this will be only a 2/4 here. But at least I can. If this is a 5/5, oh, this is bad actually. I mean, they had to have all these removal spells, because I had pretty nice selection of cards here to deal with the situation. But yeah, the worst thing was that I was kind of counting on this killing the War Master, but no, they had to peek in there. I mean, this will be a 5/5 if they draw a land. I can't block it. I can double block it, but then I will lose both of these. If I sack this before anything like that happens, like this will only be a 4/4 with the counter, so I don't know, man. I guess I have to kill the... Don't have actually... Yeah, I have to kill this thing now. Let's do that. Maybe now I will have stuff to sacrifice for the Predator. They don't necessarily draw the land right now, although I don't want them to draw spells either, but... Oh, come on. I would have gotten the... You know what I would have gotten. I would have gotten the +1/+1 counter from this thing. But that was a good top deck opponent. Hmm. That was an insane top deck now, because I would have gotten the 3/5 here. That would have actually been able to stabilize. I could have, you know, threatened a triple block on this thing. When it is 5/5, I would have killed it. But, I mean... Predator is just better. I mean, that's just super annoying. Well, I kill this now that it's only a 1-1. And now there's a land. Okay, fine. Fine, then. So this is gonna be a 5-5. These are gonna be... I'm gonna jump block the War Master and kill the... I don't know, Disciple, I guess. They will all get death touch, but... doesn't matter when it's indestructible. Yeah, I can't kill this. This will be a 5-5. Right. I don't have a bounce spell, do I? I don't want to kill this. If they have something that returns stuff from their graveyard, I don't want them to return this Disciple, I suppose. I mean, if I not draw another land, that's gonna be... maybe I shouldn't have played a land there or something. Oh yeah, I forgot I can exile stuff from their graveyard, sure. It has even that ability. So now if I draw a land, it's gonna be bad. Well, Nico Aris is definitely not bad. I get to get... okay, well that was probably all I needed. This, I mean, one good draw step for them, one good draw step for me. So I will... this will kill the War Master when I cast this, so that I can activate one of my shard tokens. Right. Then I have drawn two cards. This will deal 4 damage to a tapped creature. So I simply make this make blue, and this is a white, and then I will have shard token sacks for 2. Okay, so I'm gonna have quite a few of these shard tokens here actually. X will be a 3. Scry and draw. Now that's gonna be a good one. Bye bye, War Master. And I'm not gonna let them attack for 2, and they would kill Nico in fact, so. Let's not attack. It would become a 5-5 and things like that, but. I mean, I might even be able to. Well, this plus 1 isn't really that great. But I can make a shard token or something. I mean, I can make this. Okay, what's gonna happen now? Well, I mean, of course they equip no matter what. If they attack here, well, let's see what they attack. If they attack, okay, they don't have an attack. So now I'm just gonna... activate this thing. Pick. Yeah, it's a plus one, but I don't think it's that good. Maybe I'll wait with that one. Do I wanna... well, I'm gonna play this now regardless. That's gonna happen anyway. Oh, and I forgot I have to glimpse the cosmos, and of course I wasn't smart in my tapping. But well, this thing has hexproof, so it's quite unlikely that it would... that it would die here. So now I'm going to attack with my... before I use the Nico for anything, I will attack here and I will exile the War Master now. Like so, it's gonna be a 5-5. And I mean, I could just blast this. I didn't want to use it on the creature, of course, because it returns to my hand. But I could make a shard token, or... well, I guess it's just more valuable to create a, you know, card drawing thing here. I guess my Bomber Rays now are doing some work here. So that has hexproof now. If they drew like a pump spell or a Jarl of the Forsaken, you know, Jarl of the Forsaken doesn't work. They have to have exactly a pump spell here. Mammoth Growth. They did have it. Sure. It doesn't have Trample. I could make this indestructible, but don't really think it matters. So now, because I did a mistake, I couldn't now cast the Cosmos for now, but I have other ways maybe to cast it still. And I guess I have these shard tokens, so... Yep. Okay, there's one giant and... Now this should be pretty much over now. So I'm gonna... I could kill this guy, by the way. But, I don't wanna lose my Nico right yet. Up to one, so I'm gonna target no creature here. And it doesn't even... I guess I can do this no matter what. So now I will leave the blue here. So I'm gonna actually take here, that's blue, snow, lands, and this, and this, and I guess I don't have any reds here either. Use this before I lose the opportunity to do so. Yeah, the Ogre Raven is good. And then I can simply... How many? Two to equip. Well, I guess I'll just... equip this thing. Okay, let's... I mean, that this kind of place, if they have some mass removal, but I suppose I still have my Planeswalker here anyway. So let's take this away in case they have the crown in their deck. Okay. So this will make a creature unblockable, so I have the win here unless they find a flying blocker here. And returning the Bergstrider back, by the way, that's kind of useful. Okay, with the counterspell, this is now... Can't be blocked, yeah, this is now... guaranteed win. They have only one card in the hand, and if it's something that messes up with my plan, I will counter it. Alright. Well, that was a pretty timely Nico Aris there. Well, I guess that's why the game is exciting. Any top deck can be something great. So this is a straight up green and black deck. So based on what I saw, I'm definitely gonna have the mass removal here. They don't have a... Okay, this is a giant, but that was the only changeling I saw. And then there are these stuff. Yeah, definitely I'm gonna have the rat effect against that deck. But how about the Arnis Lace the Troll? That could be also good. Yeah, they have small guys. I might want to... Well, how small it is in the end. Okay, maybe it's not that great. But the Brat is. And I need to cut. I do want to play the Iron Verdict. They are attackers in here. Masked Wandal. There's the peak. There's the longbow. There's the... Yeah, well, come on there. This thing too. So yeah, Masked Vandal is in, but should I maybe have even two? I think I might want to have two, but now he's gonna make it very problematic to make some kind of a cut here. Maybe they saw it coming against their deck. But it's gonna have some good targets there. But I have to cut two cards here. I mean, maybe I can consider cutting a land on the draw. Fine, let's cut a land and then 30 seconds time. Fall of the Impostor, okay, maybe they don't have any that amazing target for it, so I'll cut that one too. Alright, that's it. Well, there are the colors. Also Cosmos Charger. Well, I'm gonna play the blue land, of course. I'm not gonna play the amulet here. And this will make the foretell costs for these things smaller, and if they have a... They have a Dream Devourer. So next turn... Yeah, okay, that doesn't actually matter much. So, I mean, if they have a four lands on turn four, then I can't really... Well, I can, you know, surprise block this, but of course they can make it two, three, unless they are missing land drops here. Oh, they did miss their third one. Now this could be pretty good, unless this is a mammoth growth. Yeah, if it's a mammoth growth, it's not so great then. But I'm gonna try here. Let's see what happens. They might, you know, foretell pre-combat even. Okay, they did get. Okay, do I want to get? It can be a struggle for Skemfar too. Yeah, I mean the risk that it's a mammoth growth, it's just, let's see if they pass the priority like a... Okay, they actually didn't... It didn't seem like they have it. Or they could also, you know, have their auto pass here available. That's kind of annoying because this is... I could have a free kill here, but if they have a mammoth growth, that is gonna be so bad. I mean, of course they don't. Now I see your bow. I mean, I'm stupid. These can be any cards. And they are any cards. Fine. Yeah, it's not so likely that they have a mammoth growth now. Yep. Because I kind of forgot that. Sorry. This, you know, exiles any cards. So I was just thinking what foretell cards I saw in the game one. And I saw mammoth growth and I saw struggle for Skemfar. But now I realize that, yeah, they can be pretty much anything. Anyway, now let's continue the game. Look at my lands here. Four mana. Don't have the predator, but I guess I can leave with that. What I can do, I can have the saw it coming up. So I will do this, of course, on this turn, so that I can cast it on their turn. And then at the end of their turn, I can have the Ogre Raven. I can exile that. Even if I use the counter spell, in fact. And I probably will counter anything they play here. I mean, well, maybe not anything. This is gonna be a pretty nice one. Let's say... I mean, that's actually... I mean, I have to... Vandal, this is gonna deal 3 damage to me per turn. I don't care about it. I win this race here. And I might be able to just simply kill it. Alright, well that's interesting because I have the Masked Vandal. I could... Well, I don't think I'm going to actually, you know, discard an Imbristrum. Well, then again, I might. I don't have the black mana in here. I could leave the Saw It Coming still up here. Yeah... Okay, that would be maybe a bit weird. But I'm doing it. So here it's gonna be like this, and I will lose life because I'm not gonna discard a card, resolve, lose life, pass, do this thing. I don't have second blue, but either way I'm gonna just play the Vandal here now. And I can leave the Zoid coming up. And I try to just win with my flyers. Of course, at some point I really want to play my Ogre Raven, but I guess I don't do it until I have either drawn another blue source or used my counterspell. Like so. Now I will have 6 power of flyers in here, and I can even attack with the Vandal because they don't have a good block for that one either. Well, I'm not gonna use this against, you know, killing my own flyers. Well, I'm glad I don't have to play it. I guess I could, I mean, try to find a blue source with the glimpse, but it doesn't make any sense. I will just play this now, because I'm not necessarily even wanting to draw a land with this thing. I might want to have something better. Well, I guess I take the damage here. This thing requires 6 mana, yeah, total. 6 lands total. Disciple. Well, you know what? Battle of Frost and Fire is quite bad. And Spirit of the Elder God, not so much. No reason to. Pre-combat anything. I mean, if they have their, you know, mammoth growth or something, they can kill my Vandal. It is actually relevant because if they don't block it, they would have been at 3, and now if they kill one of my flyers, they are still surviving here. Alright, so I don't actually need the black. I don't think there's any black here, but I might. I'm just checking. Oh, I have a path to World Tree, which I'm, and also of course the Heldahl. And I need double blue, but I have gladly an ice tunnel, which is both. So this is actually perfect land here for this board. Sure. Oh, I have the packmate here too. Well, this is just a perfect hand. I mean, yeah, the starting hands for me have been quite okay here. So I can foretell this on turn 2, then I have the Glittering Frost. I can even maybe have a turn 4 giant, 4-5 giant. There's no hurry, you know, to. There's no hurry to actually cast this. I'd just rather play the Glittering Frost on the island. That's pretty perfect here. There is also that, which I'm actually going to foretell this instead, because it will make foretelling the packmate eventually even cheaper. But I think my turn 4 will just be the amulet here. It's gonna be a 4-5. I'm on the play here, so it's unlikely that it's something they can deal with. Okay, another black-green deck here. Alright. So I'm gonna put this non-snowland here. So I will take 2, and then I will have a 4-5 that has hexproof as long as it's untapped. And then I can have a Cosmos Charger. I mean, I know I could have surprise blocked this, but that's somewhat risky. Oh, well, I mean, that's a nice synergy. They will get a 2-2 when this dies. But I'm not worried about that stuff. Not really. Oh, let's see. The Giant's Amulet requires blue, so I have to tap this for double blue, just in case the software would make some stupid mistake. So I need. I'll play the mountain now. So that should halt their attacks unless they do have a pump spell. Okay, packmate is good, but they don't have attacks, which is great. And I have a flyer. I have also that, but there's no reason to play that right now. This thing can kill something, but only the 1-1 currently. Definitely not going to play that. Let's put the final snowland here from my hand in there. And then end of turn, I will Cosmos Charger and then foretell this on their turn. This only hurts tapped creatures. Yep. I can also make the pack mate, by the way. Okay, that actually doesn't do anything because of I have a 4. Yeah, it does something because they are indestructible, so they can just, you know, attack here and don't have. Oh, why would they attack with the 1-1? Because they want me to take 8 damage. Oh, well, that's perfect for me. Because now I get the free kill on the 1-1. Because. And I can still prevent, you know, damage here. I take only 4 here. But that was a good attack for them. They definitely want to sacrifice this to deal 4 additional damage if I didn't have this thing that I happened to have. Anyway, what I was gonna say that Nico Aris and the Pac-Mate is a pretty nice combination. I can get the, because it returns it to my hand, the plus 1 ability. And that means I can draw even more cards. Even more cards from it. So now I'm gonna use actually the Nico here. I think. Let's count the mana first. I will. Well, let's play the Pac-Mate. I mean, I'm gonna play the Pac-Mate anyway, because I can deal 4 damage with this. And now that I'm gonna draw 2 cards thanks to the Pac-Mate here. So. I need blue-blue-white for that thing. Which means I'm gonna have this and this right now. Right. Blue-blue-white is available still. And that's a Glimpse the Cosmos, which will be fantastic here. I will play the forest because I will maximize this. Yeah, X will be 2 now. 2 shard tokens. And I will kill this for 4. 4 damage to this thing. And then I can actually. I mean, I could start the race here. I might. I mean, if I lose the Nico, it doesn't even matter that much. If they don't have anything. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna play it a bit safe now. I mean, I have so many cards here that I should win the long game as well. I don't need to race in here. And I kind of force them to have something. I have a 4-5 blocker for the Kennel Master. Now, if they attack to Nico with both of these, I will have to lose my Pac-Mate and lose the Synergy. Or if I don't block, of course, then I lose the Nico and I lose the Synergy anyway. But that's only a good attack for them if they can make the Kennel Master survive the block from the Giant's Amulet. Giant. Way down there, it's okay. Okay, let's see what they have. I'm definitely blocking here. They just want to get rid of the Nico. Well, that was a good deal for me. I got rid of their 4-4. Oh, well, they actually do get rid of my 4-4 too. Well, that was good for them, but I still have the Glimpse, which actually will with the Lichara Kinseekers also. Get the secondary cast. My opponent has like an aggressive green-black deck. I guess that can work in sealed still, but I'm not that convinced. I mean, if that's the best deck the pool can give, and I haven't seen their bombs, they might have some crazy bombs like Warring Glex and a rune. What's the rune scarred demon? Or what, something like that. Let's now see. I have options because I could kill the Berserker with my Skemphar Eldahala. I can draw a card with this. I can. Yeah, I guess I don't lose my Eldahala yet because I have the path to the World Tree. I don't have the mana activation for it. I'm actually gonna have 6 lands after I play this and fetch an untapped land, but that's not enough, of course. I could just Glimpse the Cosmos first. I'm gonna make double blue with this, but I'm gonna actually use green here, like so. That's gonna leave me a blue mana. Okay, that's a good idea. Great Hall of Starnheim. I guess the Sculptor is pretty good with the Glittering Frost, so let's do that. And then Horse Spirit, Wind Sculptor. I'm gonna just play this now. I'm gonna get an, I suppose, an untapped land after all. I mean, I don't have options much. Let's take the snow land here. And then I can play the Sculptor or the Kinseekers. I don't know if I need really the. Oh, I don't have blue or green mana. Well, in that case, let's play the 2-4 here and attack with this thing, right? I mean, this should be. I mean, unless they draw one of something insane now. With the path to the World Tree and glimpse the cosmos here. Pretty good stuff. If they attack with all, I'm gonna block the 2-2 here. Okay, that could mean a... Well, it's a free attack for them, actually. Yeah, yeah, let's block this thing then. They do this anyway, no matter what they drew. Okay. And that should be pretty close to game over now, because I guess I'm just gonna do this. I gain life, draw cards, I'm not gonna get decked now. 2 damage to creature, opponent loses, oh man, this is such an opponent, creature, and the rest happen automatically. And I will glimpse now too, why not? Let's counter something they might have. Yep. I will clock them now. I still have these 2 card draws things. Yeah, I can drop to 11. When I can end up with the counter spell, that's pretty much going to be it. Yeah, what do I show? I can show the sculpture and fall of the imposter, perhaps. And Bergstrider will make me win because I have exactly 7 here. So the opponent must have a pretty fast start. I guess they can with the Kennel Master, and if they have... I don't know. Well, definitely they, I saw 1 shapeshifter, but all the other cards I saw from there, they die to the mass removal. So I'm gonna sideboard this thing back in again. And I didn't see any... I didn't see anything that the masked Vandale actually kills, so I'm gonna sideboard it out, even though this is decent against the 2-2s I saw plenty of. I still have, you know, 3-3s, which can easily block those things. And it's also good with the Glimpse the Cosmos, but I guess I have a few ways for the Glimpse the Cosmos. How about the Brine Barrow Intruder? Is it something like a... No, it's a 1-2, it doesn't really... battle with those. If I saw some 1 toughness creature there, that would be a reason to maybe play it. So, is that just going to be it? I mean, if they have a fast start, that could be a... But yeah, Crippling Fear also would be good, but I don't... I will have some difficulties making the double black happen. It basically needs the Glittering Frost, or me drawing both the Swamp and the Great Hall of Stoneheim, or the Woodland Chasm, or 3 lands only. Yeah. I won't be sideboarding anything else now. Okay, restart my Magic Arena. What update is happening today? Okay, I don't know. I could be related to the arena open that's on the weekend. Well, this is just a perfect hand. I have the sculpture into Snowland into turn 2 sculpture here. Turn 3 Spirit of the Elder God. Oh man, if the opponent doesn't get to kill the sculpture, I can't know how could they easily win here. I even have the backup plan of, you know, just playing the Cosmos here. Or another sculpture, I suppose. So this will get me some other color, not a black or a... Yeah, it's gonna be red or white. I guess the red is more important. I have to... Well, that's a good card. But yeah, I have the... come on. The Battle of Frost and Fire, which will be, I think, better than the white cards I currently have. Well, unless I draw the one of the white cards right now, of course, that will be... a different thing then. So guess I'm gonna just play the No island for now. And then I will get... Oh, I do have the Simic Drift Whale. I don't need the chasm. I have two green sources, two blue sources, actually three blue sources. I think it's just gonna have to be the mountain here. I have this, and then I have this Immerse to Imperator. And I have some white cards here too. The Verdict will be the, I mean, the best white card. The Fall of the Impostor is not so great, and the Nicaris is, yeah, definitely the mountain here. My red cards are higher impact now, currently, than the blue cards. Can't block that, it has many. Okay, well, I did sideboard out the Masked Vandals. What this means is that I have to sideboard them both. Them both in, because this is the card you can just lose to. Okay, I have the Elder Hall for the Harald here. Although I do need double black. But I have the double black with the Untappers. But yeah, I need to trade with the Chariot here, and they will get a third token. I just can't help it. If they have anything to mess up with the trade, I'll just lose on the spot. But that's how it goes. I'm not gonna play the Kinseekers quite yet. It doesn't get the... It doesn't get the boost. But I guess I'm gonna play this and... Oh, why did I tap them? No, I'm so bad. Well, the Frost and Fire will deal with a couple of things here. Alright, well, that's a new game plan. But yeah, that was a stupid tapping of mana, because I can't untap the forest. It's not a snowland, so I was planning to play this, but now with the Battle of Frost and Fire, I'm not even gonna do that. And actually, I do play a snowland here, though. Not the Skenfire Eldahall. Just to make this a 4-4. And I could have 3 mana here, but there's nothing I can cast with it. So, if I can trade with the Chariot here, and then I can continue with the Battle of Frost and Fire, that could win the game. But if they are not gonna attack with the Chariot, they will still have it available. On the other hand, when they don't have any tokens, it's not so great. It is a crew 4 after all, and only a 4-4, and I will be able to deal with a 4-4. But definitely, if this goes to game 3, I'm gonna have both of the Masked Vandals in. There's like no question, this is such a bomb. These are not giants, this will die no matter what to the Battle of Frost and Fire. There's also a chance that I'm not gonna play this on the next turn. Although I think it's quite a small chance, but it's possible, depends on what they play. I really hope they attack with the Chariot here. That's my hope. I will double block it, of course. That's absolutely going to happen. Well, they're not gonna attack with the Chariot after all. Or are they? Yes, please, yes, please, yes, please. Okay, now I win the game. I mean, not necessarily win the game, but you know that it's gonna tip the scales so much. This Chariot, they could have given it indestructible too if they... well, I mean, I guess... Anyway, this doesn't matter. They get to copy that and it will die then. We'll go to blockers, I will block this, and then I will block this to prevent most damage, and then everything will be wiped. Oh, the opponent doesn't appreciate me doing that. I'm sure they will hate it. When I get the pearl, I get that thing too. And I will get my Scry 3. Bam. And I have the combination with the Elder Hall and the Kinseekers if I want to have the 3-5 happen. Okay, they are... That stuff now, what do I want to have in here? I mean, all of them are actually quite okay. Nicaris is the way to trigger the chapter 3 here, so I guess I kind of want to have a Nicoaris next turn. I have to, and of course, if I want to draw any else of here, I guess the Fall of the Impostor is good, but the Goldwain pick not so much. So if I can't basically play the Path to the World Tree this turn, I guess I'm just gonna play it safe and yeah, I'm gonna just play the, I mean, it doesn't matter if the Kinseekers isn't gonna be. By the way, do I have a, I have the Glimpse the Cosmos here, but I'm not gonna cast that one either. Yeah, it doesn't matter if the Kinseekers is just going to be a 2-4, they are gonna be good blockers for that, and that's the optimal use of mana this turn, and next turn I can play the Nicoaris, and if they are ending up attacking here, they might just play a land and kill the Sculptor, which is fine. If they attack, I can kill something with the Nico. If they don't attack, well, let's see what I do then. But I will play Nico as a 5-cost spell minimum. And I do have the mana for it. Double blue and white. I will... Okay, that, there's that. It'll be... I mean, I could double block it, of course, but then they wouldn't have a tapped creature. I'd rather just block here and see what they have, or do they have anything, and then I can block, kill this. They will get a 2-2, but yeah, then they'll get a 2-2. I live. Could be a Jarl of the Forsaken. Okay, they have like a triple of those things. Funny. Well, I mean, I guess I'm going to play Nicoaris. I sadly don't have another blue, white mana, because I would have wanted to have the Impostor. No, actually I do, because I can untap this, but then this won't be a blocker. I will be taking actually a lot of damage here now. So that does kind of mean that, because I will get the card draw from this, but I guess it depends on what I draw here. Anyway, this is gonna be what I'm gonna do right now, and then one of these, and I guess the red is not so needed. I won't be using more than 5 for this thing now. I will get 2 of those shots. This will trigger the chapter 3 here now. So let's see if I draw something good. Okay, so do I need an untapped land here? Kind of want to have it. Yeah, I don't... I'm gonna lose this Elder Hall. It's a good one, it would kill any of those, but I just don't think... I have to do this, like, now. I want to have this as a blocker. And I will get the Swamp, I guess. And then I will... kill this guy. And then I just have to simply take 6 damage, even more if they have the land and kill the Sculptor. Well, then I'm gonna lose in... Well, no, I will... Well, yes, I don't think I can survive that, kind of. But if they want to... Oh, they have to actually attack the Nico. But that's only one creature, if they can remove the Sculptor. 2, if not. Because Nico will, of course, you know, it's just a -1, so it can kill any of those things just for me. After I have drawn one card. Okay, that's... Okay, they didn't have their land, so... They can't kill my blocker. So this thing can... Okay, the Berserker, which is a 3-3, will attack the Nico now. The rest will attack to me. Okay, no. That's fine. That is fine, so I'm gonna... Pass to blockers, and I'm going to kill this Forsaken. I could save myself 1-2 damage and kill the token instead, but the Forsaken can trade with the... Although I guess I play the Packmate and the Impostor next turn, Fall of the Impostor. Oh, I would be going to. Okay, fine, that makes sense. I have the path to the world tree. That will kill the Jarl of the Forsaken. So yeah, that was like obvious block there. Yeah, no problem. Ask. Oh, I don't have it. Well, I still have the. I mean, now the opponent has an empty hand, and if they. Let's not do this thing. I need green and white for that thing. We could have another 3-3. That is going to be better than the. Although it's not so good, but now it's so much depends on if they draw an untapped land or not. But I don't have a lot of life here. Okay. Two blockers is better. I guess I can eat. Well, I can trade with one of the Jarl and then he kill the Berserker and take like 5 damage. Yeah, it's gonna be a close. It's gonna be very close. Yeah, the Masked Vandal was good because I was gonna gain two, kill one of their 2/2s, and get a 2/2. And of course, draw two cards too. Okay, so that's. Oh, by the way, did I somehow miss that they had the lands already for that? I guess. So, how do I not die? That's 10 damage they're doing, so I have to actually block at least. 3, but if I leave myself at 1, I will die. So I guess this has to be the block anyway, and then I probably have to jump block the 3 power guy, and that leaves me at 3, which is not gonna be very good. Yeah. Okay, I will lose this game unless I draw something. I mean, opponent had really. I mean, imagine after the rat I had, they still drew very well here. Oh, that is. That's good, but I need a lot more blockers. I can kill the Jarl here now. I can block the 3/3, and that's still 4 damage. Okay. This doesn't do anything right now. So let's find a blocker then. Cheap one. Actually, even one other blocker wouldn't have been enough. Yeah, I kill that, and I block the 3/3, and then I block one of these, and I still take. Yep, alright. Funny, I didn't win here after playing the Wrath effect. That was pretty. Yeah, the fact they got them. this thing. That was the one that won them the game. So they have a lot of those 2/2s. Well, that makes my 1/3s actually good by just, you know, existing as a 1/3. And what is the least? I guess the Fall of the Impostor goes away, right? Right at the beginning, and then. Well, they have their Masked Vandal. I don't know if I'm gonna sideboard my stuff away because of that. I guess it could be the peak. Yeah. Do I need other early blockers? I mean, Elven Bow is one other Vandal target for them. Arni slays the Troll. They have a lot of 2/2s, and I play the Arni slays the Troll. I don't have a lot of those red sources, but I think it's still something I wanna do. And here, one last cut. The Bind the Monster is just such a good one mana removal spell. Saw it coming. I guess I could see not playing the counter spell here. Okay. They have the Chariot, but it's a 4-drop. I don't necessarily get to keep mana open at that point. in the game. Okay, I forgot to update client. I guess I can play this, finish this match. I mean, of course, I wasn't gonna update it in the middle of a match. I have to try to do it after this match. Opponent attached to Mulligan. I have the blue plays here. That's the reason I kept this hand. Of course, I lacked the red mana for that thing, but I have my blue and green mana here, and I have the turn 3 flyer. And this is gonna be a good blocker against all those 2/4s anyway. They kept 6 now. Okay, that's gonna be fantastic. It gets me the snow mountain. I mean, it could also get the glade. What's that? Simmerdrift? Come on, what's that? Well, you know what I'm talking about. Now I'll play this, and I guess... Oh, let's play the snowland. This will be a larger. Well, that's annoying. And it's not even something I wanna... Well, it's something I need to slay the troll. Yeah, I will do that. That's exactly what I will do. I hope they tap out next turn, because my spirit of the Elder God will be large enough to slay it. Unless they have some removal. But yeah, just tap out on whatever. Maybe not the... Esika's chariot, that would be bad. If I can get rid of the realm eater here before it grows to 4/4. Yeah, if they have a struggle for Skemfar, that is going to be annoying. Then this would be a 4/4, so the. Okay, yeah, that's a kind of a free attack. They will do that anyway, but I'm definitely taking this damage. I just need them to. Just need them to tap out for something nonsense. Not anything that removes my stuff. Well, that was the chariot. But I guess... I just need... This is a... Not an artifact. Okay, well that... This curve out from... They did mulligan to 6, but they... You know, they have... I'm sure they have a good mana curve in this deck. But this curve out with this rare and this rare... That's the way for me to lose the game. Anyway, there is not much to, you know... I'm obviously doing it like this now. Killing the Sarulf here. And I will have a 5/5 guy. I can keep those counters then on the following turn. Do I want to use the Binder Monster? That just simply doesn't do anything. I guess I'm gonna double block the chariot. That's pretty much the thing I'm gonna do here. And this is gonna get me what exactly? I have a white, red, black. I have green. I guess I'm gonna take blue and black. That seems like the... Oh, wait a second. No, this is not the... I mixed it with the... This thing. This doesn't get the snow land, it gets a basic land. Alright, so green. Do I want to have a snow land just in case? No, I don't need a green. Okay, so it's gonna be a snow island. Fine. And yeah, I could tap the something, but it doesn't do really much here. I actually have an extra mana for the world tree here, because this will add red mana unless it's hard. I can choose not to put the counters on anything, then I will get the red mana anyway. Okay, Raven Wings on the chariot is gonna be bad. I wish this was an enchant creature or artifact. Well, it's not. Alright, Raven Wings is gonna be problematic. At least I have the Ogre Raven now at a 5/5, so they do need to find an answer to the Ogre Raven. But I take, in the meanwhile, a lot of damage. Yeah, that card is... That's pretty nice. Of course I can just draw one of my two masked Wendels too. That's gonna help me find it. Okay, I'm gonna give the counters on this thing. And do I want to now... Let's see what I want to do, because I have the 7 mana now. I could use the Path to the World Tree. Yeah, that's gonna be the... I mean, I will draw 2 cards, so they lose life and this will take 2 damage in here. Iron Verdict will work against the Ezika's Chariot. If I have... Depends on... Well, I'm gonna gain some life at least. If they deal with the Raven, I will still be dealing... gaining 4 from the Spirit of the Alder God. Okay, so things are not that bad currently. They go for the attack. I mean, I guess they might want to just trade with the Raven, but I guess they have some kind of like mammoth growth or something, but... Okay, they could also have a... Jarl of the Forsaken. They haven't dropped a land yet. Okay, I'm gonna trade with the token only. Because I want to gain the life from the spirit here. Okay, I got rid of the chariot. That is good. Now I will get 4 life. And things are now much easier. They do have, you know, this Raven Wings in here, so I start to need to clock them. Need to start clocking them, and I will... Guess I do like this now. Glimpse the Cosmos first. Creature or a... Yeah, creature is gonna be better here. And if I want to... I have only 5 mana here. Do I wanna use the Iron Verdict? Yeah, I guess I'm not gonna get the Kinseeker. Yeah, fine. Let's attack for 5. I'll play the Kinseekers then. I guess they have the Jarl of the Forsaken, so they can kill the Kinseekers anyway. Oh, again, I forgot that. I could have played the island and... Oh my... That was a mistake. Yeah, that was my bad. I should have played just the untapped land and cast this, because now I kinda don't wanna block with the Kinseekers. I think this is gonna be a Jarl of the Forsaken. Oh, that's bad. I wanna have to glimpse the Cosmos, I just wanna have it. I can find, for example, my masked Wendel or something like that. I'm gonna go to 12 now, I would be at 14 otherwise. But at least, okay, so that wasn't... That wasn't Masked Wendel. I mean, Masked Wendel. Jarl of the Forsaken. Okay. That's a good one. But yeah, first, I still have the mana for the Yeah, all that stuff. There is the masked vandal, which I'm gonna take, of course, because that will get rid of the ravenous wings. And now I can attack with my. I will have 4 mana available. Let's see, I can leave the Iron Verdict up too. Yeah, I'm not gonna play the Giant's Amulet right now. I'm gonna kill the Raven Wings. They don't know about it yet. So if I want to play a sixth as a no permanent, I need to do it. I want to do it pre-combat so that they will take an additional damage there. And by the way, I'm very close to having a win here because I could tap this and I could deal 8 damage, but 8 is not 10, so. I'm guessing I'm gonna just have the sculptor in here. I have another green source here. And now I will attack with this guy. And then I will have a masked Vandal. I do have a creature here, right? Auguru Raven. I should have maybe checked that a bit earlier, but I did indeed. And now, do I wanna bind this guy down? I suppose if they have something like a. Yeah, if they have a, you know, a Mammoth Growth, I'm not gonna die if one of these comes through. And if they use this Eldehall, they tap out on that entirely. They also do have a masked Vandal of their own, so they might be able to kill the Giant's Amulet or the bind the monster here. Okay, so I'm gonna just do this block here. Now I'll take whatever the Packmate is gonna deal here. They can now finish up the Kinseekers and have, you know, jump blockers for the Spirit of the Elder God, but it's fine. They will have to jump it with one, and then I have the Giant's Amulet, and Iron Verdict will kill the Packmate for sure now. I'm pretty sure I do it now. I mean, of course they don't necessarily use the Eldehall. That would make the attack quite bad. They only dealt 3 to me, and they lost. Well, I guess they lost only one token and the one other traded. But they do need to block the Elder God, and if they will have only one blocker, I can tap it down. Unless it is the. Well, no, even if it's the one that gains them 4 life, I do have actually 8 power of attackers here. I have 8 minutes here only. Opponent has still almost 14 minutes. I've been. Well, I guess their deck is a lot more straightforward than mine. Okay, so now my plays are gonna be straightforward too. Well, especially with that. Okay, so this is gonna cost me 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm gonna use the Verdict and Amulet. So basically, I don't have the Cosmos mana. I would need 8 mana for that. Okay, then I'll just make them jump block now. Let's use the Verdict here right away. Just to make sure it dies. Then I have the blue mana here available. Now they can have a masked Vandal for the amulet, but that doesn't do anything to my 4/4 giant in here. Next turn I can use the Cosmos and, you know, use it again. And there's a flyer. So they have to jump the. I mean, I could have a win here now. I guess what I do first is just like this. It screams a bit. Yeah, this will be good. Can't cast it now, but. Now let's take the other glimpse now. And what to do, what to do. Don't actually have mana for the Bergstrider, but I'm gonna still, of course, pick it. And I can... guess I can force them to jump block with both. I mean, yeah, I know I could bind the monster, but my hand is so good that they could still have something like an exile spell or something. I'm just gonna play it very safe here, and I'm going to actually just cast this at the end of their turn. They can have, in theory, a mass removal spell here, and I will have a hand that still wins after them mass removing this board in here. That's dead. Warinclex could be dealing 6 to me. Okay, there's no instant speed mass removal, I'm pretty sure. Okay, so 2 matches. And I did win them both. They both were against the black-green deck. Pretty interesting that didn't get any multicolor deck yet against me in a sealed event. I have to now update the software, so I will make a cut here. But of course, we will return immediately. Okay, so let's continue with this 5-color monstrosity. Okay, yet another starting hand of not having any mana issues. I have my 2 main colors and I have early plays available and also the spirit here for the you know, further mana fixing. I don't have either the black or red for this guy, but I mean I will find them sooner or later. Okay, Pilfering Hawk. Well, pretty easy. You know, I can just try to, I mean, unless the opponent starts looting right away, there's a chance I get to surprise block it. Because they do have the snow mana available. But I suppose if on the next turn they have a 4-drop, then they won't use the... Okay, well that's annoying. Do I need the double blue? I mean, I guess saw it coming is just something I might want to have. So let's see. This has death touch, sadly. So I guess I hope they will attack with the Pilfering Hawk as well, and I get to have the free kill there at least. I mean, the Varagoth, I don't think I'm gonna block that. Okay, definitely not now. Please don't have anything other than the bow stability, I mean. They are thinking about it. I mean, if they have something that kills the Cosmos Charger, they probably want to play that, right? Could be Jarl of the Forsaken, and that's exactly what it is. I was kind of hoping that I could survive with this thing, because I had a nice turn 4 coming up here, because I could have foretold this for 1 mana, kept the counterspell mana up, and then also, you know, foretold this on the end of their turn. But I mean, my turn here isn't that bad still. I'm gonna just play the spirit. of the Elder God in here, and what am I? I guess I could. There's actually a reason to, but no, I have the path to the world tree. I will get all the, you know, colors here, and colors for the predator. So I will just take here the maybe the yeah, because do I need double? Yeah, I might want to have access to double green here. So maybe it's gonna be the woodland chasm here, and then that's gonna be my black source, and then the world tree will get me. Will get me the red soul, so I get to play the predator. Sadly, the Varagot can attack now, but then again, it is a slight Tempelos, so if they don't have anything specifically great there, they might not even want to use 2 mana for the activation of this thing. And if they do, I probably have to leave the so it coming up in here. Although that would be okay. They didn't use it. Okay, things are different now. So what do I do? Playing the snowland. They can start attacking with this guy. I'm actually in a trouble here. Yeah, the death toucher is no joke. Definitely. I have 4 mana available. I could have 5 if I play the path to the world tree, but that would leave only 3. So I guess the best way to do this turn is to either foretell both of these or play the glimpse and then foretell one of them. I guess the glimpse. I might need to find something, so let's take the glimpse at this point. Okay, well, the bind the monster will be good. Yeah, I need it. I'm just wondering here that I mean I could play the path to the world tree and get a island and play the bind to monster, but I suppose I'm not gonna do that right now. I'm gonna just do it like this and no attacks. So problem here is that the Varagot still has death touch and I cannot trade with it, and they have a snowland for the Yeti. I'm taking 3 there if they so choose, and then I will take here, I mean, 2 additional damage, because obviously I'm not gonna block a death toucher. Okay, now they use that, so now I basically have to have the sword coming up. It is 3 mana. It's quite a bit, and then that would also mean I can't play the Ogre Raven. But I will have this. This will be a 3-4. I can play the bind the monster, and I think I have to bind the monster there. The unblockable guy. I can bind the monster it, and I can foretell this, and then have the 1 blue mana available here to counter the spell, but I don't know really. If I don't play a snow permanent, I can't block this. Well, I can block it with a 3-3, but then I can't use the... I guess I'm not gonna bind the monster it quite yet, because that will tie the mana too, so I guess I just want to play the path to the world tree now. Don't need to wait for anything. Just to not miss the land drop, mostly because of that. And also to get the snow permanent in here. And then I can... basically if I want to leave the counter spell up, that's the only thing I can do here. Okay, I can foretell it also. So maybe I'll just have to leave it. Yeah, I'll block the Varagot with the Spirit of the Elder God. I mean, that's the best thing I can do here. Okay, they still make that thing unblockable though. they wanna find another one. Good god, man. Oh, that that's exactly the problem with the counter spells. I left these two mana up for no reason now, because they don't have any play there, obviously. And I have to leave this up. At least I have now the island. That means a couple of things. First of all, I could use the path to the world tree. But then I can't counter anything, which is very bad. Seven mana here. Problem is that this, I need to block this thing. Unless I play like an Ogre Raven. No, I don't have enough mana to do all I want to. I would have wanted to play this and play and equip this and then still have the counter spell up and to bind the monster up. But that's just not the case. I mean, I have to do this, otherwise I'm not gonna be able to do it, because it's gonna deal that much damage to me. So there's that. And then I will just simply have to, I'm gonna simply play the Ogre Raven from my hand and block with the Forsaken, and then have the counter spell up. That's like the only thing I can figure out here. It is very sad to block the Jarl here, but I have to world tree up. That could deal with it, but I'm not gonna drop to one life, even if I could get back to three with this thing. Yeah. Time to counter this thing here, and then. Now I need to. Okay, Glimpse will be good, and the Predator will be good. How much mana that is? Seven. So I'm just gonna play my guys now, right? Well, Packmate is good, but I can at least it's not unblockable. They are, by the way, missing land drops here quite badly. So what I'm gonna do here now is, can I move around there? This is costing 2 and 3 to equip, then 1 to move around. So that's 4 total, and then this costs 2. Yeah, and I get the treasure token there, so absolutely I can do this thing. I don't have any other red here in the main deck, I don't think. Yep. Amulet, that's good. I can't even play it now, so I guess I'm gonna start raising it, because I will have a 4-5 blocker against this thing. It has hexproof, so let's go. Deal 7 here now. Let's get rid of that. I guess. Whatever. Flying blocker, maybe. And the, oh, I have a double glimpse here, by the way. So, what I need the most here. Oh, for this, I need green or black. So, I guess. Might as well say green. I get the black from the, and I will lose a green source when I use this, so let's say green. Green is fine. That will be exiled, so indestructible doesn't help. I still have a flyer here, I still have a ground blocker. Finn will be annoying though. So I just have to. Well, first of all, I'm absolutely going to play my glimpses. Wandal. They don't have anything. But I don't need to land here for anything either. If it's nothing else, it's a jump blocker. Okay. And then the other glimpse. Well, what is this? I can kill the fin with combination of the, I mean, actually, let's see, green, white, blue, black, red. I can actually kill the fin with the world path to the world tree here. Yeah, now I know what I'm gonna do here. So, guess I'll take the snowland. I don't need all the. Actually, I need the black here, definitely. So let's do this. But now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, this should be enough. I mean, if they attack with the fin, I can, you know, deal 2 damage to it. I guess that works somehow, let's see. Because I will deal 2 damage and then block with a 2-2. That's what I'm at least trying to do, but let's see how it goes. I mean, the opponent has 4 spells in their hand. Mistwalker is fine. Actually, with the peak, I can still continue the attacks with the Ogre Raven, although I will die to the counterattack, so that's not such a good idea. Let's see if they're gonna attack with the fin here. I mean, not, of course not, because they don't, they want to, you know, tie my mana, which is wise, of course, but, I will have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can play the Masked Vandal and leave the that thing up, so suppose I'm not gonna use that quite yet. Okay, well, that is good too. Actually, that is very good. I can play the Peak and I can attack. Because I just counted it's 9 mana total, right? It is. So play this, don't use too much of the green mana here. Oh, this is gonna be a bit risky, but I mean, I have to do something here to, you know, try to win here. So, could re-equip. Don't see it making much sense, so let's not do that. Because they can deal me 4 damage in the air, but that will tap all their mana. They can attack with the fin, but I mean, I can take the 1 death touch damage. The 2 poison doesn't matter at all. They will get something back with this thing. Another Yeti. Alright, right. So now they actually. Alright, so they. Yeah, the path to the world tree. Actually, yeah, they have to block now the Ogre Raven or they will die. They will have to block all of my guys, in fact. That means that the Finn will trade with the Lindworm. But it's fine. I could use the Skemfa Eldahl to make the Finn 0, but I don't actually mind if they do that, because if they double block there, they might have to jump with the Saddle's Packmate, and if they do that, if they don't do that, I can kill the, yeah, I can kill their board now. Yeah, I can trade with the, Finn. The Finn with the Lindworm. Now they can of course have something in the instant speed, but we will see. They can do that, and they can do that, and I will try to kill the Yeti, of course. Let's see if it's gonna work. Like so, and then I will just... I mean, I kinda want to maybe just use the World Tree here. Yeah, I mean, it's time definitely to use it. The opponent creature. Yep, that's fine. How do they scry now? this event is taking a lot of time. I mean, I've used 12 minutes on this one game here. I need to really pick up the pace here. I don't want to lose the time if it goes to game 3.
Okay.
Alright. And when I was making the cut, they bottomed them both. When I was making the cut here, I actually by the way, I will now first do stuff before I'm gonna play the land, of course, but do I want to play this as a 2-4 or wait until I get this? I guess I'm gonna play this as a 2-4 just to get some pressure here. Okay, yeah, I mean, the part one where I had the deck building and the first two matches, that was already very long, so this is gonna be a very long video, so sorry about that. Okay, so that's that. So they did get the life that so that the Ogre Raven isn't going to be now lethal quite yet. Well, how about that? Well, let's just quickly do the reasonable thing, which is gonna be attack. Now I can make with the... I don't have two white. Yes, I do, because I have this thing. I could make another flyer for myself. Out of the 2-2, for example. I do want to block this guy, though. That's annoying. I guess I'm gonna play this just now. Okay, let's play this guy. Not gonna be able to destroy anything. And I could make another flyer, and I could... Actually, it has a vigilance, right? And I can make it permanently hexproof. Sure. That's how I'm gonna pay for it. And then I'm gonna have to sacrifice a creature, which is gonna be the masked Vandal or the 2-2. I guess the Vandal is slightly worse, so let's do that. Keep it hexproof. And well, that's it for now. Let's hope they don't have a flying blocker here. And of course they do need to have two ways. They can have a removal and then a flying blocker. Two removals won't be enough. They can return something. None of these gain life though. So maybe the Lindworm. Yeah, well, I'm not gonna kill the Lindworm. I'm gonna jump block it with the 2-2, that's for sure. They could in theory have something like a Mammoth Growth, so I'm not gonna die to that kind of stuff. But oh yeah, I need to play the second game very fast. That's a good one, but I have three blockers here, so that's not gonna be enough. Yeah, that's not gonna be enough. Don't even know why I jump blocked everything here, but I suppose I did. They were tapped out anyway. Okay, so now this sideboarding time doesn't take away from my game clock, but... So they have a Mistwalker, they have a... Did they have another Mistwalker there? Pilfering Hawk. Couple of Yetis. So this is mostly blue, green, and then also black for all this stuff. Finn is annoying. I didn't see a target for the Vandal though, so I suppose I'm gonna sideboard it out. It's just a 1-3. Well, these are good cards there. I mean, it's just a matter of who draws better cards. I guess I have those flying guys here. Although the Mistwalker can block the 3-3 flyers, so do I want to have... How about the Raven form, by the way? I don't think I need this kind of card drawer. Anyway, I'm not gonna play the Masked Vandal, that's for sure. Something is gonna replace it, but what is it going to be? I mean, it could be something like a Elven Bow even. It could be the other pick. That's not the worst idea. It could also just be the Raven form. Because the avalanche color, for example, is pretty annoying card. I might want to get rid of the 6/6 or maybe even the, this. But then again, the 1/1 flyer, it is kinda okay against me. Do I want to have the... I guess those... No, they are, this is a shapeshifter. There are... Although there are guys that are dying to my... And I am on the draw here, so okay, I'm gonna have the Battle of Frost and Fire, and I guess Arnie slays the troll. Slays the troll is gonna be good enough to beat the something they have here, maybe. Although I don't really like to lose anything here. I actually don't want to lose anything here. Okay, forget it. That's the deck. Okay, so now I will be playing fast, so I don't maybe explain everything. Okay, again, that's a good situation. I have only blue out of my main two main colors, but like I said, in the deck building end of it, that if I have a blue source and then a glimpse, that's good. That's a good starting hand, and I should play the tapped land first. Because I will get to dig three cards deeper to find the green, and at some point I am gonna find it. Now I could go for the... Ah, okay, so... I guess I want the green as fast as possible. I'd rather trade the packmate with the fin than the... than the flyer here, so I'm gonna do this and try to... Okay, well, I actually have a way to deal with the... I mean, there's also the Pinter monster, that would be a bit safer, but... Let's see, I'm gonna be at 2 poison, then I play land number 3... I go to 4 poison, I play land number 4, I go to 6 poison, and I play land number 5, right? Unless I made some stupid mistake, this Battle of Frost and Fire should be the chosen here. And next turn I'm going to... I can even consider playing the Oguru Raven here, if I really need to. But I would kinda prefer to... Oh, they have this thing. Would kinda prefer to... Well, that peak is gonna be played now, maybe. Oh no, I mean, no, not yet. That is just stupid. Thing is, I'm not gonna actually play the Oguru Raven here next turn, because I'm gonna... I have the 5th mana here, so I will be able to play this on turn 5. Even if all thing... The only thing it kills is this, I will still play it, so... I guess I'll have the packmate now for Toll, just in case I draw the green source. I might want to play the packmate anyway. Even though it's gonna die. It depends on what they have here now. They have nothing. Okay, they do have their own packmate. That's fine. Okay, so now I'm just gonna take the damage here. That's very good with Finn, by the way. Okay, this is actually perfect. I don't... plan on showing the red source to them, and I'm going to here only do this pretty... I mean, I can use all my mana, which is fantastic. I can foretell this thing, and I can play the peak now, and then next turn, bum. Unless they have a disdainful stroke or something nasty like that, which I really hope they don't. They can also have something that saves them. Maybe they just tap out on something. Yeah, exactly this way. That was a good sideboard card in. I still don't have my green source, by the way, but I'll find it at some point. Scry 3, for example. Okay, so it coming is great. Do I need the... No, the snowland is not necessary. I have 2-3 snowlands. Yeah, it's enough. So the green is, of course, needed. Next turn, I can't play anything that... Now, do I want to have them? Okay, Packmate will draw me the counterspell. Okay, that's what's gonna happen, so let's do it like this. I can't get the chapter 3 to do anything, but I suppose I'm gonna leave with that. And what I'm gonna do here now is play the Snow Plains, and... this will cost 3, and then I can... I guess I could... No, I could cast this, but then I can't cast this. So it's very simple now, I guess. Just pass the turn. But the opponent knows what's up. they have seen the Cosmos Charger, so I'm pretty sure they're just gonna... They are just going to loot with that thing. No? Well, let's try then. They have only one black mana up, so let's see what's it gonna be. Did they forget this thing? I suppose they forgot this. Didn't I get something? I thought I had played that. Well, I mean, anyway, doesn't matter. That thing sadly doesn't do anything, but let's play the forest and this thing. And now I will have the sword coming, and I can actually foretell this for one mana, so I can do a couple of things here. I'm actually gonna foretell it right away, because otherwise I will forget it. Now it will be available as a counter spell on the next turn. I can... Yeah, I don't play the... No, actually I can play the pick, because then I will get the treasure token. So definitely do that. Definitely do that, and then... I'm gonna play the Ogre Raven, and I can counter spell with the help of the treasure token there. No, that's fine. With a crown on that thing. Well, I can take the damage here. But they do get to clock me a bit. But then again, so do I. I have the Spirit of the Elder God. No, I can't decline it. Yeah, I'm not gonna die right away. But it is gonna get close, that's for sure. I can also make it actually a 4-4 flyer. Well, that's making a lot more sense, but I do want to have the sword coming up. Anyway, I'm gonna just attack with everyone. Less than 12 minutes time, so I guess this game is over soon, no matter what. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mana. This costs 4 total. This costs 4 total. This costs 2. So I can do it, right? I think I can sacrifice the charger now. And then I will have the Spirit of the Elder God, and I will get an untapped land. Or, well, I mean, depends on what I have here, but I have an island in my hand anyway. I guess I can get just the snow swamp here. And now I have the... I will have the counter spell up, so I'm going to take here 4 damage when they equip and make it unblockable. I have a flying blocker if they, I mean, it's gonna be a 4-3 flyer, but I can block with the angel if I want to. They also have the faceless haven, but I have a blocker for that thing too, so that's definitely gonna be countered. And that should be game over now, pretty much. Because they have to block with the Yeti now, and I can also do this thing. I have only 8 power in there. I mean, I have more than enough blockers, but they have 1 mana up. What do I do here? I guess I'll take the Lindworm. It doesn't really matter because I have enough, you know. I just do like, I don't know, let's do it like this and then finish the game. It should be, 1 mana shouldn't help them. Yeah, that was won by the Vrat effect I sided in. I haven't sideboarded it in every match, or have I? I have. Maybe it should be in the main deck. Nah. Maybe I'm just a stupid for not running it. But it is better on the draw. And I had one game where I had in my hand where I was the aggressor, and there was I basically discarded it for the Eldivan Disciple. Whatever the Ravenous Rats Elf is. So yeah, I'm gonna continue with it by not having it in my main deck. Again, I do have even the green mana here, but Glimpse the Cosmos is all the enough reason to keep it. I guess I'm gonna have the Whale as a white source because of the fall of the Impostor and the Iron Verdict here, and also Nico Aris. Now I don't have to find my Snow Plains. I mean, I guess I can draw it, but I hope I don't draw it. I don't need double white, really. Well, I guess there could be a turn where I want to have the Iron Verdict and one of these. Opponent is, by the way, at 5 cards currently. So this could be easy unless they get a very strong 5. And of course this... Well, I have the Glimpse the Cosmos and I have the Nico Aris. If nothing else, I can play this even at 3 mana. Although I would need another blue for it, and I'm not gonna mention blue on this thing. I'm gonna say white here. I have a lot more green cards, green mana sources in the deck. I think I have only one white, and it's the Snow Plains, if I'm not mistaken. The dual lands are blue, black, and green black. Okay, so the opponent kept 5 cards. I'm gonna glimpse next turn, hopefully find some kind of business. Well, that's the blue for the Nico Aris for turn 3. Let's see if I find some better turn 3 play here. Mm-hmm. Well, that's gonna be the Bergstrider. So I can play this and I can make a shard token. It's a bit suspect, but... Well, let's see if they have a 2-drop. It pretty much depends on that. Oh, they had a 1-drop. I was wondering a bit what's the, you know, the card they're having. Now I can just kill this for free and I will... Oh, the Omen Keel. Man, well, I'm gonna Iron Verdict that thing. That's for sure. So I'm gonna Iron Verdict the Omen Keel because they're gonna attack with it. Now they should attack with the 1-2. The Omen Keel doesn't have haste, so I wonder what they are thinking about here. But I mean, this is a good start for a 5-card hand. They have a 1-drop and then a vehicle that activates at... I'm glad I'm on the play here, because otherwise they would get a free attack in with that thing. Guess I'm gonna just foretell this thing just in case they're not gonna offer me a target. But I suppose they're gonna have the Omen Keel happen now. Wow. Sarulf. So that's a nice curve from a 5-card hand. So now the thing about the... Let's see, can I even kill this next turn? Because I would need to draw 2 cards in order for me to be able to kill it. And if I... Yeah, I can't actually do that. That is problematic. There's no reason for me to do this now. I could kill the intruder and then this Sarulf is just gonna attack this and become a 4-4. No way. I'm gonna do it like this. I'm gonna Bergstrider Sarulf on the next turn. It will stay tapped. It will be a target for the Nico Aris. So let's see if they have a 1-2-3-4 curve here when they mulligan too. Well, that's not quite that, but pretty good anyway. So what I now need, another untapped land source. I really hope this would have been a land there. Because I can play this with X equals 1, and then if I get 1 shard, and then I can activate the shard, draw card ability, and then I can use the second ability here to actually make it so that it deals 4 damage. Oh, and I always forget the glimpse. Well, I have the glimpse now available. But, oh yeah, this is not the draw card, right? It's put 1, yeah, sadly. And that's sadly not a untapped mana. So the Nico Aris isn't gonna be that great. I mean, it is still... I can play it for... I mean, I have options here. I can just glimpse and play the Kinseekers, for example. I guess I'm gonna glimpse now. Let's see if I find the green mana finally. There is the green mana. Let's do it. And then I just think I am going to... It's pretty slow to do anything else, so... I mean, I could play these sculptures eventually, and then this would be a 3-5, but I'd rather just, you know, play the mana optimally now. Open this, I mean, could you only hold the land or something like that? Maybe I even attack for 4 now. Okay, I will try to see if this attack makes sense. Because now the Sarulf will untap here. But I kind of want Sarulf to... Oh, what? They had a land, I guess. Because I did want Sarulf to attack here, because now I had, you know, the 6 mana play available I was talking about earlier. But they just... I am assuming they had 2 lands in their hand and they didn't want to, you know, face all this. And I have still 4 spells and stuff like that. Anyway, is this text again one of those that makes me want to sideboard the mass removal in? I will be on the draw here. And I saw the Omen Keel, but I suppose they're usually going to use the Kozima on that thing. But the Glittering Frost is a good target for the Masked Vandal. I will play one Masked Vandal here. I'm not sure if I want to... Not sure if I want to have the mass removal effect in here. I guess I could have the Raven Form for the Sarulf. It is quite annoying. I don't like to give the 1/1 flyer, but it's something I can do. Okay, maybe the Raven Form is better than something. Sorry. No, I don't think I can play it. I want to have the counter spell. I guess the Masked Vandal is one of the few cards I actually want to sideboard out, because all the other have some kind of role in this deck, and even the Goldwind Peak is important, potentially giving me mana and certain colors here. So I'm gonna not sideboard in the mass removal spell now, but I will see if I want to do that for the potential game 3. Okay, perfect mana here. And I have the green place and the blue place here. This is just, I have gotten so good starting hands in this event, I can't believe it. I mean, the more colors you play, the better starting hands you have, I suppose. That's not very logical, and this is not even best of one that, you know, has those kind of fixed starting hands. Well, what I'm gonna do here is... I guess I just want to start with the flyer here, try to, raise the opponent before late game even starts. I will have a good ground blocker in the Spirit of the Elder God. It will, although it will be a 2/4 currently, unless I draw more snow things. I don't really see I want to glimpse anything. Okay, that's one other reason to not have the, the mass removal that doesn't hurt giants. This is a giant. Alright, so now that they have a 2-drop, I'd rather actually block it with the ground guy, so I will play this on turn 3. In case they have some kind of trick. I don't want to block with my flyer and then they can somehow kill my flyer with some trick, so... Let's use the packmate for blocking duty here. Yeah, that's fine. Let's play this. If I draw tapped land. I did not, so let's play the Snowland now. So I have 3 of my colors. I will get a... I guess I'm gonna actually get a white source, because I have more white spells in the deck than I have other colors. Let's see if this resolves first. It does. Yeah, let's take the Snow Plains, I think. I have black, green, and blue. I think the only red card I have is the Predator here. And of course, if I draw the path here, I can find my red mana then. But I have several white cards. Three. Fall of the Impostor, Nico Aris, and then Iron Verdict. Alright, alright. Let's take Plains. And now I can attack. Although they double block. No, not a good idea here. But I don't want to trade this to, you know, either of one of those things. Am I ever gonna get the Kinseekers triggered? I guess this deck doesn't really have a lot of creature types. Shared creature types. I kind of want to find something for this. But I have a lot, not a lot of stuff for it though. So, can't even have the Giant's Amulet right now because it requires double blue. I guess I'm gonna just play a flyer then and start the races. Hopefully they don't have removal. I guess the Realm Eater, I mean all my permanents are 4 costing permanents right now, so even if it gets some counters, they can't, you know, wrap the board, but it will of course be bigger and that's going to be annoying, obviously. Now they have also colors just like I do. Port of Carvel, that's 7 lands total. Well, I mean, they are 1 land short from that, and they do have the black-black-blue for it, so if something dies, they can return it. They can return it. But I guess bird, bear spirit, wolf. Yeah, I don't have shared creature types now. Guess before anything else, I'm kind of worried that they have so much mana available and 3 cards. I mean, I could attack with the Spirit of the Alder God after I've played my snow permanent here, because these won't kill it, and if they block with that, I don't think I mind, but maybe there's no reason. Let's see what they do to my Ogre Raven. I guess they're gonna kill the Raven, otherwise I'm, you know, starting to clock them. So we'll see what happens. Okay, they didn't do anything quite yet. I have only 1 blue source and all these blue cards, so I have to kinda... I mean, I kinda want to say red on this thing, but then again, having access to multiple blue sources just is too good in this situation that I'm actually gonna do that instead. Maybe I will start with the glimpse though. Yeah, I will start with the glimpse. Well, there's a Bind to Monster, which is not exactly good with this, because if I bind it, the triggered ability can happen, and this is a 1 mana card, so they can kill the bind right away. So it's gonna be a Nico Aris for sure. And then it's gonna be this guy for sure. And then this is gonna say blue. Now this is yet another reason to have several blue sources here. Okay. So what they do now? They had 3 cards, all the colors, 6 mana total. And they decided to do nothing. That could be like a rat effect or something. I don't know. I mean, of course, they could have like a ton of lands in their hand and some very situational spells or tricks, like a bounce spell or something like that. Okay, so they get to trade there something that is very bad. Sadly, I don't have a bounce spell in here. Can this help me? Maybe a little bit. But the Alder God isn't really the best possible thing. I'm wondering why they didn't take the flyer. So they're gonna get to trade something else now. This is a zombie wizard. Does it help me? Bird? No, it doesn't help me with the Kinseekers. So this will start tapping my stuff. Okay, that now this is a reason to actually have the other of those masked vandals in. So they're gonna trade a couple of lands here, but I have, well, I guess there's some lands that they want to. No, it's non-basic. Well, they can take my Symmetric Whale if they give their red. Okay, this, I get the red Symmetric Whale if they really want to, or I get the Chasm. They are not gonna give me the Port of Carvel, I can tell you that. So, what am I doing here? I don't know, actually. guess I'm gonna attack with the flyer. That's what I can do now that they don't have mana to tap it. And I guess it's gonna be Giant's Amulet. They could trade the amulet and the pillar, but I think they're not gonna take the amulet. They wouldn't even get the token there. Yeah, let's do it like this. I can cast the Glimpse the Cosmos post-combat then, so let's leave the one of the blue manas up here. So let's do it like... guess I'd rather do like this. And this. Okay. Path to the World Tree, Great Hall of Starnheim. Now that Path to the World Tree will draw me cards, and the token can easily die when the Saruf gets some counters, so it's gonna be the Path to the World Tree. I can still have two. I mean, I can just cast this other one. I can also actually untap the... Alright, let's do it. I have a lot of life here. Cosmos Charger is gonna be a better one of these, and then I'm gonna still actually untap this, and let's go for it. And the mountain is here. Well, that is... that was a lot of... but what was the storm count that turn? I think it was quite high. Opponent didn't really care about playing this match at all. I mean, I understand it's pretty demoralizing see me draw, like, I mean, play double Glimpse both. I mean, I guess the other one was in my graveyard, but I mean, I still play cast three Glimpses on that turn. I'm at six cards in my hand, and this doesn't do anything. And the, yeah, the third chapter does, you know, drain me three life, but I had a blocker for the guys. I had the flyer in here. They have a tapper, but I had all this stuff. So I understand why they scooped, and probably that also means that they had something very either only lands or something completely useless in their hand there. Anyway, this was my Sealed deck event number 5, and this was a 4-0 again. So can you have a better run? Out of 5 of these events, I have 4 times 4 wins. One was 2 wins, and out of those 4 win results, I think 3 of them were 4-0. I'm pretty sure that the first one was 4-0, and the third one was 4-0, and this one was 4-0. I also had a lot of different kind of decks. I think I had 3 2-color decks, 1 3-color deck perhaps. Oh, I don't remember what was the one, and then this was the 5-color deck. Let's see it once more. So yeah, this was a good sideboard card, and it's completely possible I should play this main deck. Yeah, I'm not so sure, but I guess I was very lucky in my opening hands. I didn't have to really mulligan anything. That was very lucky opening hands for me in this event. Let's claim the prize now, and the next sealed deck event that I'm gonna upload will be play and upload. Of course, I record everything. Every limited event I play, I record and I upload, no matter how good or bad I do in them. So the next one will be Arena Open. Before that, I will have a few traditional drafts happening. Let's see the profile now. I have I'm still at rank 92. I don't actually remember. Was it like when was it when I? Was it like an over a week ago when I ranked to Mythic? Well, actually, I don't remember when I did rank to Mythic. Anyway, it was 55 then. So there's still 10 days in the season, but it seems like I'm not gonna drop to 1200, which means I'm not gonna have any premier drafts this month in that case. But yeah, I hope I have this kind of success in the Arena Open, because I'm gonna play only the best of 3 sealed. I don't like to play the best of 1 sealed. Because I think if you go, is 4-0 enough to, it is single elimination in the best of 3s. I think 4-0 is enough for the day 2 invite, and now out of my 5 sealed deck events, I have done 3 4-0s. So that's kind of looking good for that. Of course, the opposition there can be much harder, who knows. Anyway, that was enough of talking now, and I will see you in the next video, which will be traditional draft. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.